Cutting an onion on the internet has become surprisingly controversial. I spend more time than I ought to on TikTok, and people are surprisingly emotional about how they cut their onions.
People have nothing to do in their lives.
I mean, I'm the one watching them.
Well, you have nothing to do in your life, then.
Hi folks, welcome back to Chemists in the Kitchen, the Umami episode. Today, we are going to be working with Marcella Hazan's viral tomato sauce recipe, which consists of four ingredients. The tomatoes, some source of fat, today it's going to be olive oil, an onion, and instead of salt, we're going to be mixing up a little bit. We're going to be using either shoyu, soy sauce, nutritional yeast, this mysterious white powder, which is Ajinomoto MSG. I use a lot of it, so I have a lot of it. And good old-fashioned NaCl, sodium chloride. And what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be making four versions of the sauce with these different flavorings, and we're gonna be talking about umami. My name's Sudeep Agarwala. I'm a yeast geneticist, metabolic engineer, and I work in biotech.
Hi, I'm Joan Walker, and I'm a conservation scientist.
And I'm Daniele Ramella, and I am an organic chemist.
Daniele, what is umami?
I don't know. Umami is one of those tastes that is probably a little more cryptic, right? We all understand very well what salty, sugary, sweet, bitter, etc. are. Umami is the one a little more cryptic. So I hope that today we're gonna sort of unravel it together.
The interplay between umami and salty, and so sometimes they kind of enhance each other, and so you can also use umami to actually help you reduce the amount of sodium. If you have a food that is prepared with a little bit more of something like a concentrate that just has this umami flavor to it, you can actually reduce the total amount of sodium in a dish potentially, which is kind of interesting too. But you still have the same sort of satisfaction when you eat it, which is always really important too, versus having really bland food that you don't want to eat anyway.
Can I share with you guys a horrible thing that I did? I usually buy crushed tomatoes, but today I have whole tomatoes. Ooh, an adventure. How do you feel about me crushing everything with my hands?
I feel that is how you cook, yes.
Okay, perfect. So I'm gonna start off with my new olive oil, Portuguese brand. Oh my God.
Are you gonna crush the olives with your hands to make the oil?
I mean, don't put it past me.
You're so strong.
That's right. First, I'm gonna turn my oven on to medium. Gonna put a glug of olive oil in, about 2 tablespoons. Cutting an onion on the internet has become surprisingly controversial. People are surprisingly emotional about how they cut their onions.
People have nothing to do in their lives.
I'm gonna keep the root intact, and I know this is controversial, and I know there's a lot of schools of thought, but I actually do not care about any dirt. I'm gonna take this and put it into my oil.
I'm still hand crushing my whole-peeled tomatoes, because that's how I normally do it as well, actually.
If I could felt like the internet wouldn't massacre me for putting the onion skins in as well, I probably would have done that anyhow. That, in fact, I've done that and it's like perfectly fine. Onion skins.
You don't need the internet for that. I'll massacre you if you put the onion skins in there.
Okay, here we go. This could be a huge disaster, but here we go. Mr. Agarwala and his food mill. Now that's tomatoes in the food mill. Yeah. Hold on, maybe that. Is that a good way to do it? Surprisingly hard to do by hand.
Simmery sauce with chunks of onions in there.
Reading up on this umami, and it's this, you know, fifth kind of taste. We have salty and sweet, sour and bitter, and then this somewhat mysterious fifth kind of taste, which is umami. It's basically like a savory flavor. And there are specific taste receptors on your tongue that respond to, or that create this umami taste in your mouth. And the molecules that they're responding to are things like glutamates, and also, so that's a type of amino acid. We can talk more about amino acids because I know Sudeep wants to talk about amino acids. But also, I was blown away by this, but also certain nucleotides. Nucleotides are the building blocks of things like DNA, or RNA, ribonucleic acid. So the nucleotides are the monomers of those big polymers. And it was crazy to me that we would have some receptor in our mouth that would respond to these broken down nucleotides.
You know, I'm buying MSG from Ajinomoto for cultural reasons and all sorts of other reasons, but like, it's sort of like these needles. And then when you sort of taste it, it doesn't really have that much of a taste.
No, I actually really wanted to do this because I've never had it like plain. And so I've never used it as a flavor enhancer before. So I just got it for this.
It freaks me out. It's like,
you know, because you've heard the term before and you see it listed as an ingredient on your, you know, products that you buy. And I was like, no, I really want to taste this because like, this is what I've heard is that the MSG doesn't taste a lot. So I'm going
to... I wouldn't be able to describe if you asked me what does it taste like. I don't know, it's just...
Yeah, it's not unpleasant, but it's not a lot.
It's very pleasant, yeah. I like it a lot, yeah. I just...
Well, and again, I think this is one of the reasons why, like, this umami, it took like almost 100 years after it was first described by Japanese scientists, and it took a long time for it to get sort of more universally accepted, like almost 100 years, because like umami, it's not like a one-to-one, like you have salt and it makes things salty. It's like you have these, you know, this savoriness that's really hard to describe. I'm about ready to taste. I think we should start with the salt, because that's closer to the original recipe as well, because like
yes.
The original recipe has salt in it.
Mm. That is salt. By adding a quarter teaspoon to a cup of pasta, I have no concerns about being able to taste the salt. It's like, I overdid it with the salt a little bit. Probably should have been an eighth teaspoon. But...
Okay, I'm gonna try the MSG mix. Yeah, oh.
That's what I was gonna say.
I love it,
other,
okay.
Serious white powder. Oh, wow.
Oh, I feel like I'm tasting a lot more of like the sort of acid, tinge of the tomatoes.
The flavor enhancer, like, I don't know what it is, but like,
oh,
I feel like I can taste more the tomato. I can taste I get more nuance.
I don't want to say debates, but properties, I guess, as well of monosodium glutamate is that it does have this synergistic effect with other things that cause umami kinds of sensations. So like they found that if you have things that have like the guanylates, the nucleotide derivatives, as well as the glutamates. If you have those together, they like enhance each other.
Makes sense. It's delicious, I'm gonna finish it. My God,
oh,
that's fantastic.
You were talking,
sorry.
I ate. Well, since the nutritional yeast are a complete surprise to me because I've never used them before, I'm gonna go for a soy sauce and save them for last.
Okay, great.
I actually really like that too. Yeah. Like it doesn't taste like a stir fry to me, which, you know, it would smell a little stir fry.
Well, a tomato in itself.
But it just has this like depth of, but it does have this depth of sort of savory flavor for sure.
I don't know if it is because I put more soy sauce or too much soy sauce and not enough MSG, but soy sauce definitely has its own flavor and aroma that, right? So it changes the taste. While MSG really I like it too. Yes, I'm not saying that I do like it, but it is a different flavor, right? MSG only brought out the tomato more. This one changes the flavor profile completely.
And like, maybe it's just the soy sauce that I'm using, but like I do feel like I smell some of that, like, I want to say chocolatey or like roasted coffee notes.
Yeah, Daniela liked it.
Last one?
Daniela liked it.
Lick the bowl clean. That's good.
And then makes three empty bowls. Yes, buddy, you'll get food too.
Oh,
don't worry.
Oh, puppy.
You're gonna get some food as well.
Oh, good boy. I know, we're sorry.
Anyways, flakes.
Last one? Nutritional flakes?
Yep,
nutritional yeast. Which I have not tried at all.
Also called, also called nooch by those in the know.
Nooch.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
I think that's good too.
Yeah, they definitely have the the funky of yeast, right? In general,
mm-hmm. No, but it gives you, again, a little bit of a, again, lack of a better word, like a cheesiness. Like if it was a cheese sauce, it would kind of be similar, I think.
Well, I was gonna say, on the count of four, should we pick out the one that we think was best?
Yeah, I think we should.
Randomly? Okay. Daniele, you ready? Daniele?
Yes.
Okay. One, two, three, four.
MSG.
Oh, mine was the soy sauce, actually.
Really?
Yeah, I'm super surprised too.
I feel like I'm betraying everybody, but yeah, the needle-like white crystals really did it for me.
Mm-hmm.
You could smell and taste the tomato better this way, and like the additional flavor didn't feel obtrusive.
I agree. And also, Joan, can you check if Sudeep has already ended up on the FBI watch list for dealing with mysterious white powders?
That's right.
But yeah, no, it's true. It really brought up the flavor much more, mm-hmm. holding back on the saltiness, but really making it more umami.
Okay, least favorite. Ready? 4, 3, 2, 1.
Salt.
Soy sauce.
Oh wow, this is really different.
It just changed it to something completely different. Like it.
Yeah. Okay.
Like the yeast or the MSG brought out some side of the tomato that is not maybe what we normally taste as a forward taste of tomato. Soy sauce just made it something different, which I like. I like soy sauce, but it's not a tomato sauce at all anymore.
I feel like I'm betraying my people because as a yeast biologist, I feel like this is great. It's got all your extra B vitamins that you're probably missing in your food. It's like it's reusing a waste product. It's waste product valorization. I really, really wanted to love this, but the smell was just so off-putting for me.
Interesting.
We did it, gang. Fun episode for a very fun word. Umami. Today, we made Marcella Hazan's famous four ingredient pasta sauce. What did we learn? We learned a little bit about this weird savory flavor called umami. Come back next time to learn more. I'm sorry, that ending was really bad.
You're fine, Sudeep.
That looked like you're very tired and you're just done and you just want to go on your
theater now. No, yeah, thanks for joining me in the kitchen today. That was really fun. It was really fun to hear about kind of some different cooking styles and kind of what your experiences are and kind of what you're bringing to the stovetop when you're boiling down tomatoes and an onion and some oil. What you're bringing to that even more than the seasonings that we were adding. So thanks for hanging out with me. It was really fun. And I hope you can all join us again on the next episode of Chemists in the Kitchen.
Later. My earphones died right now.
Oh,
that,
perfect.
I cannot hear you anymore. My AirPods died completely.